Stuart Gordon is one of my favorite directors, and his films are the reason why I enjoy H.P. Lovecraft literature. In this video, I want to pay tribute to this legend and talk about my top 5 favorite Stuart Gordon films. First up is Castle Freak, which was released in 1995, and it stars Jeffrey Combs and Barbara Crampton. The film follows John Riley, who has inherited a 12th century castle, which belonged to a famed duchess. And he's gone here with his wife Susan and their blind daughter Rebecca. Susan blames John for the death of their 5-year-old son in a drunk driving accident, which also cost their daughter her eyesight. On the advice of the estate's executor, the three plan to stay at the castle until they can liquidate the estate. Unbeknownst to them, the Duchess's son, Giorgio Orsino, who has kept imprisoned and tortured by the Duchess in revenge for her husband leaving her, still lives in the dungeons of the castle. Stuart Gordon is known for his great use of gore and practical effects. And with Castle Freak, although it's not nearly at the level of, say, Re-Animator, it looks really realistic and very convincing. It's also one of the more restrained films by Stuart Gordon. It's more of a slow burn, and there's really no humor in this film. When you look at Re-Animator or From Beyond, there's some kind of humor, and it's very cosmic type of horror. This feels a lot more grounded, although it's still fantastical in some senses. It's also more of a family drama, so it's a bit different from the other films that are later on in this list. Both Barbara Crampton and Jeffrey Combs are fantastic as always. I like the creepy setting of the castle and the mystery, and quite frankly, the gore is really good in this film. The reason I put Castle Freak at number 5 is because I think that this is a better film to watch after you've seen a few other Stuart Gordon films, and then watch this after you've gotten a taste for his type of filmmaking. Castle Freak is often overlooked, but it's definitely well worth checking out. Don't go in expecting Re-Animator, because this is very different from all the rest of his films. Next up is Dolls, which was released in 1987, and it follows 6 people who seek shelter during a storm in the mansion of an elderly puppet maker and his wife, only to find that the various puppets and dolls in the home contain the imprisoned spirits of criminals. Dolls is a very nostalgic film for me. I used to watch this over and over again as a kid with my older brother, and it was one of my favorites. And still to this day, I really enjoy this film. One of the big things I really like about this is the practical effects, and especially the dolls. There's so many cool stop motion animation, there's a lot of really cool sound effects and voice effects in this film. I also like the little kid and her buddy who's like the older guy trying to help her out, and even the elderly couple is sweet in their own kind of maniacal way. This is more of a horror comedy. It's a lot of fun. I feel like it's a good film to watch as like an introductory horror film. Again, this is one that I watched a lot as a kid, and it never really scared me. If anything, I just thought it was fun, and that would be the big thing I would stress with Dolls, is that it's a ton of fun. It's not super gory, but there definitely is some blood. Out of Stuart Gordon's horror films, Dolls is his most accessible and probably his most tamest film. If you have someone that gets scared easily or someone who wants to dip their toe into horror, Dolls is a really good start. Next up is From Beyond, which was released in 1986, and this is a body horror film, and it's loosely based on a short story of the same name by H.P. Lovecraft. It stars Jeffrey Combs, Barbara Crampton, Ken Foree, and Ted Sorrell. The basic plot of From Beyond is about a pair of scientists who are attempting to stimulate the pineal gland with a device called the Resonator. An unforeseen result of the experiment is the ability to perceive creatures from another dimension that proceed to drag the head scientists into their world, and he returns as this grotesque shape-shifting monster that preys upon the others at the laboratory. This is cosmic horror at its best. I love From Beyond. This film is so out there. It's so wild. It's so crazy. Barbara Crampton basically becomes the Herbert West of this film, which is awesome. It's cool to see her take up a different kind of role, and she chews up every single scene. Everyone in this film is awesome. The practical effects are great. The gore is great. The weirdness level of From Beyond is at the same level of Re-Animator. If you're into cosmic horror and crazy films with really great practical effects and gore, you gotta watch From Beyond. It's a fantastic film. Next is the 1985 classic Re-Animator. This stars Jeffrey Combs, Barbara Crampton, and Bruce Abbott. This is a horror comedy which is loosely based on the 1922 H.P. Lovecraft story, Herbert West Re-Animator. The plot follows Herbert West, who's a medical student, who has invented a reagent which can reanimate deceased bodies. He and his classmate, Dan Kane, begin to test the serum on dead human bodies, and this conflicts with Dr. Carl Hill, who is infatuated with Kane's fiance and wants to claim the invention as his own. Re-Animator is in my top 10 horror films of all time. I love this movie. It's always a joy to watch. Really great performances, and it's a ton of fun. The comedy is great, the body horror is awesome, and the blood and guts is just spewing everywhere. It's so much fun, it's so out there, and like many others, this was my introduction to Stuart Gordon. If you're gonna start with any Stuart Gordon film, I definitely recommend Re-Animator. Jeffrey Combs is so fantastic in this film as Herbert West, and this was the first time I was introduced to Barbara Crampton, who I've been a huge fan of ever since. There's literally not one bad thing I can think of about this film. It's pitch perfect, and for any horror fan, this is a must that you have to have in your collection. And last but certainly not least, Dagon was released in 2001, and I think this film is criminally underrated. Despite the title, it is based on H.P. Lovecraft's story, The Shadow Over Innsmouth, rather than his earlier short story, Dagon, from 1919. The film takes place in Amboka, which is the Spanish adaptation of Innsmouth. The film stars Ezra Godin, and it's about Paul Marsh, who is yachting on the Spanish coast with his girlfriend and a couple of friends. Then a freak storm causes their boat to crash into some rocks. Paul goes to a nearby village to get assistance, as two of his friends are trapped in the boat. He notices the locals seem odd, and their behavior grows increasingly strange. Then Paul begins seeing a mermaid who has appeared in his nightmares, and he realizes that the fearful world of his dreams is now a reality. This is the film that got me into reading H.P. Lovecraft, and this is what really got me into the Cthulhu mythos and into all the elder gods. To me, this is the closest film that has really encapsulated H.P. Lovecraft and the Cthulhu mythos. If you've ever played the video game Resident Evil 4, you can totally see how much inspiration they took from Dagon. The film starts out a little more kooky, and then it starts to get darker and darker as the film progresses, and we're following Paul throughout this entire journey of trying to find his friends and his girlfriend. There's even a little Easter egg where Paul is wearing a shirt that says Mescatonic, which I always love seeing because Mescatonic is part of the H.P. Lovecraft literature, and Mescatonic is the school that's in Re-Animator. Whenever I meet a fellow horror fan, I always ask them, have you seen Dagon? If they haven't, I make them watch it with me because I think this film is so fantastic. It's super underrated and it's really ambitious. There's a little bit of CGI here and there and it's a little touch and go, but the overall film is fantastic. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like, and if you want to see more content like this, be sure to hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for coming by, and I'll see you guys next time.